Hi everyone, welcome back. In the previous video, I explained a bit about the system, how it works, and we made some quests, NPCs, and dialogues. And in this video, I'm gonna talk a bit more about tasks. So the first thing I did was remove from the map all the NPCs except the example one that we created in last video. This is just for clarity, and I also cleared the save games. So if you remember, in the save game folders, I should destroy them. So in this video, the first thing we're gonna do is create a task. So let's go to blueprint, quest, and here I'm gonna create a new folder. I'm gonna call this task, and inside there I'm gonna create a new task. So right click in the editor and you will see the quest category, and in this category there is the quest task object. So this is what the object for the task. I'm gonna call this BP underscore base task. This is gonna be the parent of all the tasks I'm making blueprints. This is just a good practice so you can have the common logic in here. So if you open it, this is how it looks like. You have some overridable functions for each of the events of the task. So for example, you can see there is one for task activated, task complete, destroy, disable, etc. The most important ones are the activate condition and the on task activated. This last one is where you're gonna put all the logic for the task in particular. And the activate condition is just a condition that will be checked before the task is activated. And if it fails, the task will fail. So some tasks use this only. So if you go to the blueprint defaults, the task object defaults, you can see that there is a use activate condition only. This means that all the functions will be ignored except this one, and the task will be just a condition check and it will be executed instantly. And you can use this one for making conditions, even for a condition that check before the quest is activated or accepted, let's say. So you can have access to some variables also. If you type quest task and scroll down, you can see that the task have some variables that you can use for your logic. You have the quest manager and the payload, etc. These ones are useful. And of course, if you want to add some logic to the task, a good practice is using interface. So that's what we're gonna do. If you go to class settings and you click in add, there is already an interface in the system that is called a quest task interface. And this adds some functions for the Y. I use this in the example Y. We're gonna override this one that should show in UI. I'm gonna put true. So all the tasks that we create here, we're gonna show in UI, at least if you don't override it. So this is our parent task, but what we're gonna do is another one. So I'm gonna make a new folder. I'm gonna call this task again. And for the task that will derive from this object, I'm gonna create a child blueprint class. So I'm gonna call this task underscore jump. And this is gonna be the task that we're gonna count the jumps. So for now, in the top down, you don't have the functionality to jump. In the third person, you do. So we're gonna add it. We're gonna go to the top down BP, and in the blueprints folder, the top down character, we're gonna right click and gonna search for space input space bar, and there is a jump function that already comes with the engine. This one, should place it here. This one has a dispatcher that will tell you when the character stops jumping, so we're gonna use that in the task. So let's compile and save this. So most of the tasks use that dispatcher. Probably you're gonna make them. For example, if you have a dispatcher for crafting items or killing monsters, you can use those for creating tasks for that same thing. So let's go to the jump task that we created. So for this particular task, we're gonna need one of the functions. So let's go to override, and on quest task activated, we're gonna select that. And we're gonna assign to the dispatcher from the jump function. For that, we're gonna need the character. So first, we're gonna need a way of getting it. So I'm gonna get the quest manager owner. It's this one, and we know this is a flash state. And the owner of the pleasure state is always the controller, so it's gonna get owner. This is the controller. I'm gonna cast it to controller. I'm gonna connect it here. And I'm gonna get the controlled pawn. So let's get controlled pawn, this one. And this is the character. This is the character. But we need to cast it first. So to be sure, so cast to character. And now we have access to the dispatcher. So it's called something with movement. So let's assign movement. Is this one assign movement mode change delegate? It's gonna add that. I'm gonna arrange a bit. And from the previous movement mode, this is enum, so I'm gonna get equal. And we have some option here. So if the character was falling, it means that he was jumping. So I'm gonna use this. I'm gonna select that. And I'm gonna set a branch here. I'm gonna connect it. And basically, if this is true, the character jumped, so this is all we need. We're gonna end the quest task. Like every other task, we need to end it at some point, so this is the way. It's gonna be a true value, and we're gonna count shoot one. So let's comment this, count the jumps. And if we want this task to work, if we leave the game and enter, and this is already active, we need to use another function, because this one is gonna only be triggered when the task is activated. But if we join the game and this is already activated, this will not trigger. So we're gonna use onQuestTaskLoad is this one, and we're gonna do exactly the same thing. We're gonna bind to the dispatcher and count the jumps. So this is gonna be connected here. And the last part we need is to use one of the interface functions. Is this one, the short description is used for the UI. So we're gonna implement it, right click and select implement. And we're gonna type something here, so jump. So that's basically what we need for this task for jumping. So let's gonna close this. But for us to be able to see it in the editor, we need to fill a data table. So let's go to the quest data tables, that ones that we created in the first video, and we have this one that we haven't used yet. So this is where you're gonna add them. Of course, you can have many of these, so you can organize them, just add a row, and you have to fill some values. Don't be afraid, you don't have to set them all, only the one you need. So for the name, I'm gonna just put jump. The color, this is just for visual UI. Let's put something blue. The error object for this particular task is not really important, but we're gonna use the standard one. This issue tells if some variable is not set. For the title, this is for the content itself of the node. This is gonna be issue the task name. And for the content preview, we're gonna use this one, the last one. This says times to check. For the task class, the one that we created, this is task jump. We are not gonna use the string in the payload, so we're not gonna use these ones. The amount, neither. The times to check, we're gonna use this, so you can set how many times you want to count. So let's put a float selector, and we're gonna not use any of the other ones. So for now, that's it. Let's save. And if now we go to the editor, because I delete the save, there is a reset. Let's go to quest and let's make a new one. Let's call this quest jump. I'm gonna save it right away. So go to quest. Remember the data table you need to select before saving. So let's save. You can see updated. And I'm gonna place some nodes, two talk nodes, and this one for the jump task. If you go to task, you will see the new one jump, and it says the times. Let's put 5 here, so we're gonna count 5 times. If I select all the nodes and press C, it's gonna connect them. I'm gonna connect those. I'm gonna select both of the talk nodes. I'm gonna select the MPC. So we're gonna select MPC data table and the example MPC. So this question will be for the example MPC. And now I'm gonna edit the talk nodes. So this is the jump quest. Yes. Let's jump. I'm gonna just put something here, that's awesome. Cool. And I'm gonna select all the nodes and align them with Q. And I'm gonna save again. So now we have created the new quest. I'm gonna add it to the MPC. So let's go to the MPC. Let's select the MPC data table, the example MPC. And from quest, I'm gonna select the quest jump. I'm gonna add it to MPC, and I'm gonna save. So that's it. I'm gonna close the editor now. I'm gonna hit play, and new window. If I maximize, you can see now that we have the previous quest, but we also have the new one. This is the jump quest. So let's click it, and you can see that now is counting jumps. And if I press spacebar, I'm gonna jump, and it counted one. If I press again, it's gonna keep counting. And when I press, I have a new updated task. I'm gonna talk to the NPC, and this is the final node, the tongue node that says awesome, and the quest is completed. So that is the basic task we created and the basic quest, and we're gonna use a little bit more of the task now. So we're gonna go again to the editor. I'm gonna open the quest, and I'm gonna add a new condition. So let's say let's use the condition that quest has quest completed from quest. I'm gonna use the example quest. So I'm gonna connect it. I'm gonna save, and now this is a quest chain. So it requires the example quest to be completed before being able to complete the quest itself. So I add a new functionality for this, for visualizing the quest chains. So if you see this button here, this was not in the previous video, but it's now, and this shows the quest chains. So if you click here, you can see that the relation between the quest now is updated. You can go back to quest. For us now to complete it, we need to delete the save again. So because we already completed this one, so let's clear the save again. I'm gonna close the editor. I'm gonna hit play again. So if you press high, we need to complete this one, so let's complete it. Yes, of course, okay. And now you can see that the new quest appears. So this is the jump quest. You can see that we can jump again. So that is a way to use the task for conditions and for creating chains. I'm gonna show you a bit more about the conditions now. Let's move the nodes a bit lower. I'm gonna add two conditions, and these ones gonna be has node state. We're gonna select the quest. We're gonna select the previous quest, the example quest. I'm gonna for now let's save. I'm gonna show you the example quest. Let's load, and you can see that we have options in the example quest. So you can complete it with this, or with this. So this node is the talk task one. We're gonna use this one, and we're gonna say, hey, if you have this task completed, you're gonna have to jump 5 times. But if you selected one of these, you're gonna have to jump another amount, 10, for example. So let's go back to the quest. Remember that was the talk task one. So select quest, example quest. Let's find here Yes, of course, this is the one. If you have this completed, we're gonna jump. We're gonna control click the node and gonna move it. So this one, you're gonna say, hey, if you have this node, the task one completed, you can have a 5 jumps. I'm gonna copy this node. I'm gonna connect it like so. And here I want to jump 10 times if you didn't complete it. But this is the same check that this one, so we're gonna go to Options and we're gonna go to Inverse Activate Condition. I'm gonna hit that, and this will say now you can see there is a admiration mark. So this is a negated condition. So if you have this completed or you don't have this completed, you can see. And now these links need to be optional, so let's change them with left click, so you can have one path or the other. So let's save. Let's clear the save again. I'm gonna hit play. Remember, if you select the option yes, of course, you will have to jump 5 times, and if you select one of these, you have to jump 10 times. So let's go with the first one. Yes, of course, this is a jump task, and we can see that this is a 5, so that's correct. I'm gonna close it. I'm gonna delete the save again. I'm gonna play. I'm gonna select now one or the other options. So if I click here, okay, and now you need to jump 10 times. So I'm not gonna do it. So that's pretty much for this video. Thanks for watching. Bye.